When I used to play a lot of weddings, the musicians in the band had a running joke that we would not play two songs during the wedding reception. Don't get around much anymore, and breaking up is hard to do. I guess we didn't want the title of the song to send any message about what about the wedding or what we thought of, you know, whatever. Just having some fun there. I'm Ron Drotos, and welcome to my journey through the real book number 99. And I hope it's your journey through the real book too, whether you're following step by step, tune by tune with me, or if you're just exploring more songs and learning more about them. That's the main thing about this too. Inspire you, and a challenge myself to just do the whole book and really, really get into it, even tunes I haven't played before. Don't Get Around Much Anymore is Duke Ellington. It's one of those chestnuts, one of his most famous songs, one of his biggest hits. It was based on an instrumental tune that he wrote called Never No Lament, which was recorded in the early 40s by the famous, what's now called the Blanton Webster Band, when he had Jimmy Blanton on bass and Ben Webster on tenor saxophone. They recorded Cottontail, a lot of other great tunes from that time. And then they added lyrics to that, and it became Don't Get Around Much Anymore, and was a big pop hit, popular song hit, because swing music was pop music at the time. And it's a great tune. Kind of has that catchy thing. That's like a hook, right? Just like in pop music now. You'll hear the melody and then you hear these little instrumental hooks, right? That's what this was. Two hooks and two measures. You have this, then this. So in that sense, it's similar to the pop music of today. And also, you hear it's contrasting, just like in classical music and in other types of great music. You have something going down, now back up. It's also a call and response. Call, response, which comes out of that tradition of African-American spirituals, gospel music, church music. So a lot of this, just in two measures. And what I'm going to do with this, I'm not going to treat this like I'm playing for dancing or, you know, sort of like sometimes the tune's played in sort of a light jazz kind of background music situation, cocktail music. It sounds great there. I'm just going to open it up because one thing that I think we sometimes forget is that even in the 30s and 40s, a lot of the swing musicians, like Duke Ellington, were very advanced harmonically. So, you know, they might play, you know, chords that we can't believe. Duke Ellington would play doubly diminished chords. You know? We think of that as Herbie Hancock. When you have one diminished seventh chord up a whole step from the other. But that's Duke Ellington. You know, that's where he got that from, you know? And so, we can take a tune like this and play anything we hear. So, I'm just going to see where it goes. I'm going to start with something Ellington would do a lot and take... in this case, I'll take second inversion triads. I'll go down chromatically while I have a pedal tone in the bass. See where it takes me. Thank you. Something I've never done before, I want to highlight it because it caught me by surprise and I went with it. You remember the intro had these triads over pedal tone, four bar intro. And what I did, if you remember when you listened to it, at some point during my solo, I started playing that as the turnaround at the end of the A sections. So I play the first six measures of the A section, and then at the turnaround, I would play something like that. And it just seemed like natural to, like it wanted to keep going. It seemed natural, like it wanted to keep going. So I kept it going for the first four measures of the next A, and then came in with the regular changes. So I ignored the chord changes. And I think in the back of my mind, I got that from this series of YouTube, checking out Duke Ellington's The African Flower, which is the very first tune in this book. If you listen to the recording, not the real book version, but the recording of Duke Ellington playing The African Flower on Money Jungle with Charles Mingus and Max Roach as a trio, he disguises the form like that. He does that. He plays what sounds like the A section, but it turns into the bridge. Actually, I think it's vice versa. It sounds like the bridge, but then it turns out to be the beginning of the A section. He's disguising the form. So instead of having, in my case here, eight measures and then eight measures, the two A sections. I really have six, two plus four, six, and then four. So that equals the 16 measures. Instead of eight and eight, I have six, six, and four. That makes sense. Anyway, disguising the form. And then even things that I just love doing. Playing the left hand up the half step. Very Ellingtonian to do stuff like that, those crunches. So just using this to inspire me and using our whole breadth of knowledge. You know, whatever we've learned, we can use in a tune like this. So good luck. Check it out. Hope to see you here again. at Keyboard Improv. If you want some step-by-step instructions, Skype lessons, whatever you need, I'm here for you. And thanks for joining me on this journey through the real book. I'll see you next time at number 100, Donna Lee.